The problem with most knife sharpeners is that they remove too much metal, all of the time, turning your butcher knives into fillet knives. But not the Beau Honer, the professional sharpening tool that doesn't grind your blades, but hones them to a level of sharpness only found in the micro world. And it's all made possible by the patented Flex design. The Honer is easy to use on all knives, whether you're at home or in the field, and weighing less than 2 ounces, it travels well. It's the only sharpener in the world that will sharpen serrated blades without destroying them, saving you money. It also handles thick blades, even axes and hatchets. And stop throwing away dull scissors. The Honer will sweeten them up in no time, even fly tying scissors and pinking shears. Use the Honer to bring back the puncture power of fish hooks. And every hunter needs a Honer to sharpen all of their tools, even arrows. It takes years to wear down the nitrided rods, but just pull and turn slightly to sharpen like new. And no matter what happens, the Honer comes with a bulletproof guarantee, and it's proudly made in America with a lifetime warranty. The Honer is used by professional chefs and outfitters worldwide who know the value of this professional sharpening tool.
In Mexico, where we are, we love the Honer. We have an entire fleet of fishing boats. We also have a great bar and restaurant, and we use these all the time. There's nothing better than the Honer to keep our hooks and our knives razor sharp.
I've been using it in the field forever. It's a great, great product. It's very small, weighs less than 2 ounces. It's easy to take, it's easy to use on a log. You can keep your knife razor sharp at all times.
And this is my Benchmade that I use with this knife sharpener. And this Benchmade right here, I could shave with. I think Bob Lebeau has done an outstanding job of inventing a really good product here. It's very popular, it's been around a long time. And I think you should buy one and try it out. They're unconditionally guaranteed. If you wear it out, Bob will give you a brand new one. It's a really good tool that every tackle box, every camp, every outfitter should carry. Run that knife right down through these two steels. We do a lot of moose hunting in Alaska, moose and caribou. And if you have one of these, you're never gonna have a dull knife.
I've got this sharpening from the show 3 years ago. I have 5 guides and take about 60, 70 hunters. This is the only thing I use. It works great to do the final touches on your knives, and my guides really don't know how to sharpen knives. So this thing will absolutely keep it fine-tuned and works great.
I use this on the field, and there's no question this will get her done. You know, when you're out there and that knife gets done, a couple swips and this will work.
Choose your color, and bright colors are popular with outdoorsmen because they're easy to find.
I love my pink Honer.
The Beau Honer is a professional sharpening tool that's been the best-selling knife sharpener at the leading sports shows for decades, with thousands of happy customers that will never use a dull blade again.
Got 2 posts here on the bottom, locates the edge of a cutting board. Put your thumb in the back, aim a dead center stroke until it runs smooth and quiet. When it runs smooth and quiet, you're done.
Now, let's join Bob Beau, inventor of the Honer Sharpener, for a short demonstration of how to use the very versatile Beau Honer.
Taking metal off a knife is easy. Taking metal off a knife is easy. These things have been doing it for decades. These things. These are my competitors. They take metal off the blade all the time, and that's the problem. So, when you need to take metal off of a dull knife, you know the knife is dull because it will not cut. So, simply take the knife, use the top rod, and knock off all your flat spots, your nicks and burrs, clean your edge up, and get your edge rough. Once you get your edge rough, you're ready to sharpen. If you don't get it rough, there's only 2 possibilities. Number one, you did not do your job. Number two, you need a grinder, not a sharpener. Now you take your Honer, and the rods are flexible. So they will flex and hug the blade, much like a butcher steel. How much metal do you think I'm taking off with a butcher steel? You're right, not much. Heel to the tip, heel to the tip, if any. And they've been using this for decades. So, taking metal off a knife is not necessary to sharpen a knife. sharp is in the micro world, so you don't need a lot of pressure to get there. Very gently. Don't push hard, don't press hard. And it sharpens both sides of the knife at the same time. Now, kitchen knives. They come in a variety of different shapes and sizes. You get everything from a butcher knife to a fillet knife to a little paring knife. They're all basically the same. All you need to do is remember, don't push hard, don't press hard. Lightly stroke the rods. Heel to the tip, heel to the tip. The rods will flex and hug the blade and make your knife sharp. On your other knives that you have that are smaller, you can stand it up and use the inside for sharpening. The angle is the same on the inside as well as the outside. And these nitrite rods will handle all metals. Just remember, don't push hard or press hard. If you feel like you want to push hard or press hard, that means you want to take metal off of a dull knife. And you know how to take metal off a dull knife because it's easy. The nitrite rods, they're 70 on the Rockwell C scale. It takes 4 years to wear them down in one spot. When you do, simply pull, turn, put it back in, pull, turn, put it back in. You have new points of contact. These rods will do all metals. 440 stainless steel, they'll do a buck knife in less than 30 seconds. But metal does not have to fly in order to get a knife sharp. Keep that in mind. Now I'll show you how to do serrated knives. Because of my patented Flex, it's the only sharpener in the world that will do a serrated knife. You know how you sharpen them now? You throw them away. That costs you money. They make them different. They're flat on one side, they have a bevel on the other. You take the flat side, not the beveled side, and you lay that over against one rod, like this. Then you draw it down and let the rods vibrate. The rods vibrate, sharpening the peaks and valleys. When these are dull, though, you still have to take metal off of the blade. Taking metal off a knife should be an exception, not the rule. Use the flat side on the top rod, knock off all your flat spots, your nicks and burrs, and develop it rough. Then lay the flat side against one rod and draw it down, heel to the tip, heel to the tip. If you're on a table, place it on the cutting board and lay the flat side to one rod and the other rod vibrates. Don't push hard, don't press hard. Never pushing hard, never pressing hard. Let these rods do the work for you. Thick blades, they have them in knives, and axes is a good example. Remember, you still need to take metal off of your axe. That's simply done by benching your axe and taking a hand file and creating a rough edge. Once your edge is rough, you're ready to sharpen the blade with the honer. Palm down, insert, thumb in the back, and aim it dead center. Stroke until it runs smooth and quiet. You can feel it, you can hear it. When that runs smooth and it gets quiet, you're done. How about scissors? What in the world can we do to sharpen scissors? Believe it or not, scissors are easy to sharpen. Open them up. You have a bevel. And that bevel may change from manufacturer to manufacturer. The steel is also much softer than it is on a knife. Take the nitrite rod and brush the bevel of the scissors. Heel to the tip, heel to the tip. Same thing and repeat on the other side. Heel to the tip, heel to the tip. And that will tune your scissors up to where they shear properly. And when they shear properly, they cut properly. Remember, scissors are shearing, not cutting like a knife. Hunters, you're out in the field. You pick up your arrow. You notice it has little nicks and burrs on there. Take your honer, use the top rod, knock off all your nicks and burrs and flat spots. Don't worry about angle. The idea here is just kind of rough the edge up a little bit. Now, you take and put your thumb behind the blade, You aim it dead center and gently and lightly stroke the rods. When it runs smooth and it runs quiet, you're done. Just like you do with a knife edge. Don't push hard, don't press hard. Light strokes, dead center. You're out on the river or the lake, you blunt the tip of your hook. What are you gonna do? Well, you grab your honer, and the first thing you want to do is straighten your tip out. Don't worry about anything except pug and pull, tug and pull. And that will straighten your tip. Now you take your tip, locate a groove, and run it back and forth. This restores the puncture power back into your fish hook. Get back to fishing. It's that quick, that easy.
Now's the time to invest in a LeBeau's honer and stop destroying your knives and wasting money with cheap foreign-made gadgets. The honer is easy to use for everyone and makes a great gift. Learn more or order online at honer.com or call the toll-free number at 888-41-SHARP. Operators are standing by.